G'day guys, my name's Josh, you can call me Zawoodle, and welcome back to 7 Days to Die, where we are back in our Hardcore Specialist series, coming into day 3 of our Agility Week. And I'm gonna be honest, like flat out, I think this is the luckiest and like the best start I've had to a week that I can remember. We've been finding all of the good gubs. We found the one, the only solitary useful book in the Needle and Thread series that gives us the double cargo pockets. We found the workbench schematic. We found bicycle stuff. We found knives. We found guns. We found everything that I could have needed and wanted, which makes me nervous. This game doesn't give you anything for free. It will wring me out like a sponge before long and take its pint of revenge. But until then, I'm going to feel good about myself and enjoy the game. The sun is about to come up. It's still pretty dark and dingy outside, but that's right. We will get there eventually in here. Now, look at that. We have our bicycle chassis. We have our bicycle handlebars on day 3, which is ridiculous. We have our double storage, our double clothing mod. Where do you go? You go into this one, modify, 2 carry capacity out of you instead of this, the regular one you get. Nice. I mean, I've even found the book that means I have maximum carry capacity at night as well. So it is all coming up Josh House at the moment. But today, my only mission is to try and find the gubs that I need to make myself 2 wheels. I make 2 wheels, I can make a bicycle. With a bicycle, I can start moving about much, much easier. So that's going to be a really bloody good time. The sun is about to come up. There it is. Let's head back on down, back through our little ladder cavity here and head out onto the town. I need some coal. I need some. What was the other thing I need? Wheel. I need coal and I need oil. Both very doable, very reasonably easy to get. For example, this like old dilapidated tree here will give me coal for cutting it down. So sorry, buddy, you have to get sacrificed for the greater good. I need your black stuff. Oh. I see you over there. I'm gonna have to take a break from being a lumberjack for a moment to make sure I can put Puppy Boy over there down, because the last thing I need is that thing coming for me when I don't expect it to. That was a good pill. Get out the pistol and put one right between the eyes. No one saw me do that. Nope, we're fine. Okay, I just don't like wolves. Wolves are scary. They hit so hard so quickly that when I'm running like early game stuff, having a pistol makes it slightly more bearable. But if I didn't have a gun, if I had like a blunderbuss and a knife, I'd be in some serious trouble if a wolf showed up at a really bad time. So whenever I see one and I can get the drop on it, I'll always take that opportunity. How much coal do I actually get out of this thing, by the way? I didn't actually check that before I did it. There's also the fireplace inside that will give me some coal as well. How much did you give me? 17. That's enough for one. All right, we're off to a good start. Let's go break down our fireplace inside as well. It was lovely for ambience, but I need the coal. Oh, it gives me lots too. Another 6. Only another 7 and we're right as rain. There's another 6 there out of the fireplace. I just need one more coal. Don't do this to me, game. You've done it before. You've given me all but one of something I desperately needed and then refused to give me even the last little bit just to make me a happy chappy. No, that's just a regular little tree. I don't think that gives me coal. Where am I going to find it? Where am I going to find it? If I was in like the burn biome, there'd be coal everywhere, but I'm not, so I have to kind of do without. We'll find it somewhere, Josh. Have some faith. Have some hope. You might stumble across it somewhere. Let's go here. Let's break down you. Some more feathers for some more arrows. Also, it used to be way back in the day, these things used to give you coal as well, but I don't think they do anymore. Maybe we can find a coal node? All right, I found coal. We're fine. Never mind. That'll just about do me, I think. I just got some extras just in case. Got 50 coal now. In fairness, I probably should look for the coal to start with before I broke down like the fireplace and the tree and stuff, but they were just outside my front door and I didn't know if I'd find a coal node relatively quickly. So now all I'm missing is some oil. Well, there's a car just here, so I'll start breaking you down with the wrench. Only need, what, like 4 oils, I think it is? That's not too many. That should be reasonably doable. All before Trader Potato opens for the day. If my stamina can kick up, for goodness sake, keep up with me, please. I'm too busy trying to figure out what I'm going to do for today. I'm forgetting how to speak. Only got the one oil out of that, which is kind of upsetting. It probably is worth mentioning as well. It used to be, like, back in, like, Alpha 16, you could break down the tires like this, and it had a chance to give you wheels, which I kind of liked back when you only had the mini bike, but now there's more vehicles. That's not the case anymore. You can still get some wheels from specific tires on the ground, but they have to be ones that actually have, like, the wheel inside it, not just, like, a regular tire. The regular tires like this don't give you wheels anymore. They just give you polymers. So, that's gone by the wayside. I have to go back and make myself my own wheels then. Another radiator I can sell you for some more money, and I'll break you down as well. Little by little we'll get there. I'm not giving up hope just yet. We're so close. Oh, that's a good get. An extra oil in there and I'll break you down. I am remembering, by the way, I am aware that I sold a bunch of oil to Trader Potato the other day, and now lo and behold I need a coupler. It's just the way it goes sometimes. That didn't give me an extra one. No, it didn't. There's one more stage to it, though. There's the extra one there. Now I have the four oils. I have enough there and enough there. Just need the two wheels. I can go back home, get them on the craft. And it's now just after 6 a.m, so tradies is open. We're making really good time. We're using our time really efficiently. I like how this is going. So I can go hand in this quest, and by the time I come back home again, I'll have a bike ready to pedal on with. Nice. 2 minutes on you. I think there's also just one mechanical part it needs to make a bicycle as well. Double check that. Two wheels, chassis handlebars, and wait. Yeah, one mechanical part. I've got 32. There's one in there for me to use later on. Okay. Nice. So that's going to take 2 minutes to craft away. I can now put anything I have that fits into any of these slots can all go away. I came up with some engines as well. Well, that's a really good... I usually struggle to find engines. I'm pretty happy that I found a couple of that easy. You guys can all go into there. I'll come back for you another time. We're going to take all of you, all of my sellables. Let's go see Tradie. Let's go make some money. Ooh, we're off to a flyer. We are absolutely ravaging 7 days to die this time around, which feels nice. Often, I'm at the mercy of this game to actually feel like I'm in control. It's an unusual but very tinkly feeling. So Tradie is actually selling some covert cats, which is sneak damage plus 50%. So basically an extra level in what I bought myself the other day. What was it? What's the actual name of the perk? Before I guess and get it wrong, Hidden Strike. So it's an extra level of Hidden Strike in a candy. I don't know. I mean, I've never really used them. I suppose, like, I usually just go for the cell shot, and if they get up, they're usually damaged enough they die pretty quickly afterwards. So it's only $100 reduce, though. Probably worthwhile if you were going through and finding rads and demos and stuff like that, like some of the bigger, badder zombies. For early game stuff, other than a biker or a military zombie, not really necessary, but I'll take it with me anyway, because...
Can I lighten that backpack up for you?
You can if you just give me a chance to get inside. Jeez, you're such a squawking pelican. What do you got for me? Now, it used to be that you could put weighted head mods in a knife or a machete. And then they got rid of that, like, halfway through my Eclipse series. It's really bloody annoying. I have heard rumors they brought it back, but I don't actually know for sure. But it is, I mean, it's more valuable and better for me than the armor plating mod, so I'll take you and give it a crack. Get a new job from you. Anything nearby? 300 meters left for a buried supplies quest. Yeah, okay. Listen, don't mind if I do. Plus, I got the bike now anyway, so yes, please. And real quick, I'm not going to sell that one, nor that one, but I am going to sell all of this. Give me all the dollary doos, please. Oh, I didn't even sell the oil yet. I went looking for oil I had in my sellables chest. That's right. If that's my bumper chip for today, I'll take it. That's not even the worst thing I've done recently. So I now have just over $3,500 dollary dues. I didn't even check. Do you have a machete at all? You don't have one in there, nor do you have one in your secret stash. That's all right. Machete is like the top level knife. You get a machete, it's like the gap between a hunting knife and a machete is ridiculous. If you can buy a tier 1 machete at any point, absolutely go for it. You will not be disappointed. But I can't be one of those, so instead, I'll buy the gunpowder and the casings, because I now have my own workbench. I can buy another workbench if I wanted to too. So now I have my own one, I can make myself all the ammo I could ever want. You don't have any bullet tips, but you'll probably have them next time around when you restock. Nothing else really in there. Check your books and things. Nah, nothing jumping out at me as things are worthwhile. That's fine. What about handgun parts? Potentially? They're only $300. I mean, $300 each. So it's $1,200 reduced for the whole lot. But it might come in handy down the road. It may do. If I'm specializing in guns and in pistols and knives, then I may as well buy the parts of it if I've ever come across it. So, buy you guys as a potential investment in my future, and we're good to go. Now, moment of truth, can I put the weighted head mods in knives still? No, I can't. That's all right. You'll always have a place in a different one. How about I put you in here? There you go. Put a slightly bigger, heavier boulder on the end of my stick. Nice. All right, let's go get our bike. Let's go do our quests. We're looking pretty good. Nice. All the bits are done. I'll take you all out of there. And bicycle, get you crafting. There we go. You may be wondering why I put, like, the chassis and the mechanical part that I needed and stuff up into here. It's just because I have to account for the fact that I am a galah. As you just noticed by the fact that I went looking for oil despite having 8 oils in the sellables chest, I just freaking forgot about. So putting it up there means that I know that when I come back, when the parts are made, everything I need is just in the output of the workbench. So I have to go looking for things in different chests that I can't see anyway because I don't have a search bar. It's fine. It's all there. Take it all out and craft the thing I need. Easy bloody peasy. Speaking of easy peasy, we now have a bicycle. That may be the earliest I've ever had transportation. Other than like getting really lucky, maybe like looting something back in the day when... What am I stuck on? Oh, I'm banging my head on that. Okay, fair enough. Let's get down that way. Oh my goodness, I almost broke my knees. But yeah, other than looting something like completely back in the day, I can't imagine ever having anything quicker than this. So I'm very happy to have a saddle to ride on. Nice, look at the speed we have now. Oh yes. Here's the joint just here, just next to the cemetery. Anyone around? There's a scozzer over there bumbling about, jiggling all sorts of his bits. All right, now. We know how these things work. If I'm here and I'm digging, let's take you guys out of there. Let's put you into the shovel instead, just some extra damagey goodness. And I need the southwest quadrant, so over this side. Even though I've had such resounding success with digging in the southwest quadrant and finding treasures super easily, it's still... I haven't, like, accepted it, you know? Like, deep down inside, I'm still skeptical. Like, if I go one time not finding it in the southwest quadrant, I'll be like, aha! I told you, I was right. That trick doesn't work, despite the fact of ignoring... I was going to say the 20 times it has worked, and now the 21st time that it has worked. Alright, well, cool bloody bananas. I'll take you. What you got for me? You have all of that. In fact, real quick, I'm going to leave the supplies in there so the zombies don't spawn yet. I'll modify that, and I'll take the burning shaft mod, and I'll put it on my knife. No, I won't. I thought I could, but I can't do it. All right. Ignore that then. Put you back in there. I will take you. I think I knew that actually from the other day, didn't I? I think I remembered that. I just forgot for a moment. Who have we got to deal with? Just a couple of? All right. That's fine. Don't mind if I do. Get you to swing. Get you to miss. Stab you both in the face to get some bleeding going on. And you guys are good and doused. Oh, you're angry about it. Sit down, please. I'll stab you as well. So you're all bleeding out. Bonds are mate level 9. Just take your time and stab him when you can. So I do have 2 skill points available to spend. I'll put 1 into that one there. Tier 5 of like your main like umbrella perk, like the actual perk tree itself before you start spending points on individual stuff. I feel like tier 5 is enough just to get you settled. Then you can start specializing a bit more later on down the path. That other point I'm going to put into... Well, now I have a pistol. Let's put it into pistols, actually. Unlocks pistol crafting. At some point, can I craft 44s? No. I'm pretty sure 44s are still... handguns and SMG. Yeah, it must be. I can't think of any, like, specific thing for magnums in here. It's all... Yeah, it's all pretty bog stock standard. Alright, guess I can't craft a 44 unless I find a recipe for it. But if I try and like spread out those points nice and easily, get all of them to at least level 2, maybe some level 3s, now I'm level 5 agility, that'll be pretty good for offense. And then like, you know, just like some points into armor, flurry of blows is always good as well. There's actually a lot of very useful perks in agility. So there's no like, you know, just a 1 or 2 that you have to focus on. You're going to focus on a lot. That was a super quick job. G'day, bud. I'm back again. I was literally only here a couple of hours ago. Antibiotics or bicycle schematic? I could sell you, but I used my last set of schematic, my last set of antibiotics to sort out my last infection I had. Shouldn't have that problem again now that I have honey, but I will still take you just as like an insurance. Now, what have you got for me? That's the next closest one, so I'll take you. It's a cave to the south, apparently.
Don't you have work to do?
All right. I mean, I'm okay with that. I was expecting to go to a building, but a cave will do as well. I've got some stuff on me. I will read the coffee recipe. It's only worth $40, dudes, and I'd rather be able to make myself some coffees when I have the gubs. So that's all looking fine. I will take this stuff home, drop it all off in the boxes upstairs, and then carry on down to the spooky cave off to the south. I don't know. I don't know what POIs is going to be. This could be interesting. Not too far to go. Made really good time making it all the way out here. Again, using that, like, stamina technique on the bike of holding shift to maintain momentum and just tapping W to keep your speed up every now and again. Here we go. We are here. Okay. Oh, I... Okay. It's been a while since I've seen one of these POIs, actually. Like, I used to live in one of these in, like, Alpha 17. Even Alpha 16, I think it was, way back when. It has been a hot minute since I've gone in one of these things. Really small POI, actually. It's like, it's literally just this little cave with some guys inside, but not much else. All right, I'm A-okay with that. Let's sneak on down. Excuse me. And just reset you right off the bat. Oh, jeez, that was weird. So when you reset a POI, it does do that. Like, it resets all the grass and stuff like that as well. Just wasn't quite expecting it to happen while I was inside the ditch. Looks a little bare bones. That looks like a crater more than anything else. But we've got some lead, some iron. Okay, but I know I can sneak up here and just, like, prop myself up on the top of this wall here and use my sweet stealth abilities to kill all the clowns before I even get inside. I thought I heard something, but nope, we're looking okay. What else we got? We got a guy. I can't aim up enough to actually hit him. Or maybe I can make that work for me. If I go like this, and I just get rid of you just a little bit, just like lift up the ceiling a little bit, that might be all I need to make that shot. Oh, that was really close. Try again. I want it. Ah, didn't kill him. Maybe if I had used my covert cats, I might have killed him in the first place. But I hit him in the shoulder. It was my shit shooter that was to blame more than anything else. So just... put another one in your head like that. Yeah, nah, we're fine. There's actually a fair amount of zombies in here, but as long as I don't miss a shot, they won't wake up. It's kind of the interesting thing about stealth. So if you take a shot, if you throw a pill and you miss completely, I was actually kind of lucky that I missed Bozza. The arrow landed behind him, but I was far enough away they didn't wake up. But if I'm shooting from here, I'm definitely close enough that they will wake up if I miss. But if you hit a zombie, as far as the other zombies are concerned, no sound gets made. So I can just kind of sit here and just take my time, make sure I actually make the shot. Even though he didn't die, he's not going to wake up all his friends. I'll try and kill Nance while he's walking towards me. There we go. Put another one to you. You're now both dead. And no one's waking up because no one's hearing a bloody sausage. Let's hit you as well. He was only a crawler. Weaker was a shit shot. Hit him in the shoulder, but he still died. Someone's mad upstairs. Do not care. This place is now empty. I'll take all my arrows back. Just as easy as that. There isn't an awful lot to write home about in this cave. Like, some iron nodes and things, that's alright, and some shotgun the side boxes. But more importantly, there are the mushrooms on the ground. And having, like, a good supply of mushrooms is actually pretty useful. Another fat stack of handgun parts, yes please. No machete parts, though. Scrap you, take the rest of that. What have you got for me? An 8x scope mod. If I ever find a hunting rifle, I'm gonna smack that on and make some real money. Take all of that. I heard someone moaning and groaning upstairs. The door is now open, so they're welcome to join me down here whenever they bloody like. In the meantime, I'll just cruise around and I'll grab all the shrooms that I can. Even if I just hold on to them until later on to either plant them or use them in, like, steak and spuds or something like that. Either way, there are many uses for them. Grab you, could get to stab you in the face. How you doing? But, I mean, I could let you have the cave if you're a little bit more, well, a little bit less grotesque. I might have just, like, left this to you. Could have been your own dowry. Now we just hop back on the bike and start heading back from whence we came, making really good time on the quests. Like, the first week really is just like, doing as many trests for, trests? Okay, brain. Gonna say quests for tradie, and apparently my brain just mushed those words together and came up with some amalgamation that we should never talk about ever again. But doing quests for trading in the first week is the best way to arm yourself and prepare yourself. Like, buying weapons from trade. Oh, I've been playing W too much. Buying weapons from tradie early days is the best way to find something good. Sure, I had trouble buying an AK, but I bought a pistol day one. And even in that Fortitude series, where I was looking for an AK, I think I saw every other kind of gun going through Trader Potatoes till I found the AK, or made myself the AK later on. So having enough money to buy your first weapon is absolutely the best way to go. Punching out quests as quickly as possible. It's not hard. They're relatively easy to do if you choose the right ones, and you should be able to make some pretty serious bank pretty quickly. Back for the third time today. G'day, bud. I mean, you should probably be used to this by now. Ooh, a forge schematic. Absolutely. Skullcap mod, kind of useful to make money, put it into something and sell it later on. But forge schematic, yes, please. Look at that. We don't have any points in advanced engineering. We already have the ability to make both of the workstations that we're going to need. This is a outlandishly good start to a playthrough. What else you got for me? I mean, I'll do this one. It's a fair hike away, but it's the next closest. Old Modular 6, fair enough. Real quick, though, I'll let them sell you some rocket launchers. I'll sell you the rifle parts, and I'll sell you the steel spear parts. Bombs are at level 10 as well. Got a new skill point to spend. I'll sell that. And we're good.
Sale is a sale.
Alrighty-dighty. I'll quickly read you, and let's head back home and drop all this stuff off. Something's gonna go wrong at some point. Oh no, the map's gonna spawn in like 7 demolishers on the first horde night or something. Things are going too well and it's making me suspicious. Real quick, I did grab those candles out of the POI I was just in because they give a lower heat increase than the torches do. They give off a fair bit of light and for like aesthetics and stuff, they look kind of nice too. But they increase the heat level that call in screamers less than torches do. So I like to use them where I can before I get electrical lighting or lanterns. Lanterns are the best ones. There is no heat increase and they're bright as fuck. So I'd replace all these with lanterns if I had the opportunity to. But that should be all the light that I need for this place. It's a relatively small room. I don't need to increase the size really at all. In fact, before I go, forge, what do you need? Small stone, clay soil, leather, duct tape, short iron pipes. I might be able to make you right now. I might be able to make you right bloody now. You, leather, and what else was there? Duct tapes. I should have duct tapes. I do have duct tapes. Is that everything? That bloody is everything. Well, I'll make it in here so I don't like clog up my own crafting system. It'll be ready for me when I come back later on. That's ridiculous. It's gonna have a nice little place right next to it. And Trader Potato had no workstations. I was a bit bummed about that to start with. I was a little bit worried about how I was gonna get things done, but turns out didn't need them. I have my own. Sometimes it's nice and peaceful just to, okay. Yeah, just like riding out through the countryside on your bike is nice and peaceful. You kind of just forget what you're doing. I came all this way and I was just kind of absentmindedly pedaling along without thinking too much about it. Or could we break down the tree stump? I think it's just outside the POI range anyway, but I want some more honey. Always have a good supply of honey on you just in case the worst happens. Plus, you make froffies out of it. It's gonna make it, isn't it? Froffy. Froffy, does that take honey? I'm pretty sure it does. No, hops murky water. What am I thinking of? I don't know. Anyway, doesn't matter. This is the POI. I need to go raiding. There's a couple of chooks around. Nah, you can live. You can live. You're fine. Nothing sneaky for me. Alright, let's do it then. Let's just go like this. Reset you, get the bow out, and go nice and stealthy, boys. After all, this is like the stealth tree, so may as well use it for what it wants it to be. I've got the book, which means I don't make noise when I traipse over stuff like that. Open you with an arrow. Nope, no one hiding inside. Alright, that's fine for me. Nice and easy first room. Oh, I just remember what POI this is. This is the one that's got like a bunch of like lab zombies and stuff inside it with like fake floors that drop you down into a death trap. So I'll keep that in mind. Let's grab that. Get it lined up with the seam and take the 20 bullets. Don't worry about the crossbow bolts. Even though, so crossbows are okay. I don't like the iron crossbow. The composite crossbow is really good. Just like the composite bow. Choose between them. It's a matter of preference, really. There's no, like, a definitive yes or no, black or white, which one is better than the other one. I refuse to use the iron crossbow because the only time I've ever relied on it, it's got me killed. So I kind of refuse to do that. I'd rather stick with a wooden bow and whichever composite, whatever I find first is what I go for. At that point, you're making yourself arrows or bolts, so it's less important. The only perk of having a crossbow is you can put, like, a 2x or 4x scope mod on it. I have one of those. If I find one at some point, I might be tempted to, but that is a conversation for later on. At the moment, I'll just scrap whatever bolts I find because I'm rolling with the bow and arrow instead. Get up onto the couch before the floor drops away. There you go. Now, they should fall down as well. Nope, gonna walk over it. That's fine. Come fight me on the couch. Ow, I can't move back any further. I'll fall down into the depths below. That's fine. That's fine. So with, like, the critical hits and things, I'm pretty sure that it's coded into the game that the first hit from a zombie won't give you a critical. You can only get critted from like the second or third or and so on. But the first hit, the first tickle is just a tickle. Just a flick of the earlobe. It's not going to like mess you up as much as it does later on. So you can cop one punch to the face and be okay. You don't want to get more than that though. You might be in a little bit of trouble if it keeps getting swatted around. But gonna play a bit of floor is lava because I don't want to fall through the floor underneath. Just jump from thing to thing. I know that whatever I'm standing on can't break if it's an object of furniture, so I can make my way through that way. Someone's mad outside, but that's okay. It's only really this like this main floor here that has the death drop underneath it. He's coming through the door. That's fine. This is where it comes out over here. It's not really that big of a deal if you do fall down. It's just I try not to, mostly because like those lab tech zombies will follow you down as well, and then you're fighting in even more of a confined area before. Like I tried to stay on the couch and fight and got hit a little bit, but that was alright. But if I needed to, if I absolutely had to run, I still had an escape. If I was down here, I've got one point of exit, and it's not particularly easy to get to when you're under pressure, so try and avoid that if you can. Sorry, bud. I didn't mean to set you on fire. I was actually trying to help. I was trying to open the door so we can have a tango a little bit better. But then apparently my dance moves were en fuego. And now you're all sorts of cooking. All right, that's fine. Come on. Come on inside. There you go. You should die pretty quickly now because you've been sizzling outside for a while. Like a shrimp on the barbie that Australians don't actually do. Kill your friend as well. Yeah, easy. Oh, g'day. G'day, Nance. Good to see ya. Sorry, Nance, that was a little bit aggressive by me. I'm trying to be as thorough as I can be in this place and search everything. Because I am looking for needle and thread kits as well. Stay off the floor, Josh. Stay on the furniture. Floor is lava is the only way to go. Yeah, because I am looking for needle and thread kits, I have to look in every trash pile, everything to try and find them. I need some more pockets. That wet thwack gets me every time. Stab you once, stab you twice. Missed the third one. That's right. I'll just let you bleed out there, bud. You're already oozing out of all your pores. You're probably in for a great spell. There we go. Don't bother breaking down the chemistry station. It does give you forged iron anyway. Anyone else in here? Just another couple in the back room. Okay, well, here's what we're going to do. We're going to stand as far back as we can to break down those planks because they hide out in that cupboard in the background there. So, open you with an arrow. There's Lisa the lab tech. Just pop one through your ponytail and count it as a miss. There we go. Try a second time. You can see what I mean, though, by how I don't really feel the need to use those covert cat's candies because they're just, like, stealth damage is fine as it is. There's not really any extra that I'm hoping for. Get an angle on you. Put you down. That was the last zombie because the quest is now done. And now we have all the loot to get through. Easy as that. Search the lab equipment box. It's always disappointing. And well, actually, glue isn't so bad. I found some worse stuff in those things over the trip for sure. Another water purifier mod. Like, actually put that into this and sell it for a pretty penny. So I might actually do that. Another weighted head mod, which I'll put into the shovel, I suppose. Not really anything else. Some ammo. A tier 3 bone knife. Nah. Okay. Well, actually, what does it take for me to make a hunting knife? I can make a tier 3 hunting knife, which will absolutely be better than the tier 3 bone knife. What do you need? Forged iron, wood, leather, duct tape. I actually have the gubs to do that back at home, so especially now I have the forge as well, I'm gonna have lots of forged iron without too much issue. So we're kind of laughing there. I might make one of those when I get back home. Although, even so, I've got another skill point to spend. I'll put it into I'll put it into deep cuts. Only because it means I won't be able to put any more points to that for a while, but I can make myself a tier 4 knife now. Even better, same amount of mod slots though, but should do more damage. And now I can focus on things like, you know, archery and gunslinger and stuff like that. I don't have the bow parts to make myself a wooden bow, which I think, yeah, unlocks wooden bow and iron crossbow at the start. So I can make one if I find bow parts. I'll keep an eye out for that, but less important, I think. All right. We're laughing. We're good. Well, it's also getting pretty late on in the day. So, real quick, can I get through here? Actually, I haven't searched these things yet. Anything in you? Iron crossbow bolts. I'll scrap you for the iron. Don't bother taking the lead and nothing in the loo. But I want to get up and over here because up here should be a weapons bag. There we go. What have you got for me? Nah, don't need you. Scrap you. Don't need that. I'll take the bullets. That was a little disappointing. I was hoping for a little bit more out of that. That's fine, though. This place is not done. There's a safe. Yeah, I've got time. I want to make my trades today. I've got time. Push, Josh. Push. There's the zeros. We are in. Only lost one lockpick as well. For another bloody ball. I'll take you. Gonna have to worry about repairing you to make you better. We're fine. I'll grab the medical supplies on the way out. Ooh. Iron spear schematic. It's worth a bit of money. Then I'm not gonna make a spear, so may as well sell it. What else is in here? I'll take you and you and you. Don't need that. Don't need those, actually. Don't need that either. Nor you, nor you, and nor you. I'm still a little bit cucumbered. That's all right, though. Might have just... Actually, I do have some pipes, so I'll repair you. All right, let's push. Let's get out of here. I want to make it back home in a reasonable amount of time. It's about a kilometer away. It's a bit of a hike. Come on, bikey boy. It's you and me. Let's get this done. We've made it back in reasonable time. The reason I was rushing so much to get back to traders is I just kind of had the thought that he may actually have some bow parts that I've overlooked. I may have even sold him some bow parts because I'm an idiot and forgot I could actually make myself a wooden bow. Close you. How you doing? All right, real quick, I will take the pipe bombs. Thank you. May I see inventory though, real quick? Bow. No, nothing in there. That's fine. Bow parts. No, nothing there either. Okay, I'm not missing anything. That's the main concern I had. I will sell you. Sell you. I'll keep you to put into this thing and sell in a second. You can get sold. You can get sold. Nothing else in here is particularly important to be sold or anything. I sell you, actually. No, everything else. Oh, I sell that one too. Okay. Everything here is looking pretty fine and dandy. Sell the brass. I don't need it. That can go away. Yep. Okay. Good. I will see you. In fact, real quick. I don't think I have any good jobs when we do now. They're all super far away. You restock an inventory tomorrow and you get new quests. So I will see you in the morning. Now it's a matter of me just pedaling on home. Leave my bike on my front doorstep. I doubt a zombie's going to jump on it and steal it. Maybe I'll invest in a bike lock or something. Let's just put you not quite in front of the door. Just there. There we go. That'll be fine. All right. Inside, upstairs, get our forge. Ooh, I'll make ourselves a new knife. That's exciting. I know it seems a little bit dicey, given that, like, by itself, a repair kit's worth $37. This is already worth $100, and that's worth, what, $43. So I'm sacrificing $40 to make... well, basically to make nothing, if you just go by that kind of sum. But if I repair... No, not that one. If I repair you like that, stack that back up again, and then put that mod into you, modify into there, complete. Look at that. It's now worth almost $600 by itself, which is ridiculously good. If I wasn't going light armor, I'd probably consider wearing that, but I'm going to get weighed down by heavy armor, so never mind. You can go into there. Thank you. I actually put you into that one just to do some extra damage with the wrench and get some more gubs. Rest of you guys, you can get scrapped. You guys can go away. That can go into there. And I mean, I suppose that does... I mean, it's just an ingredient. It's fine. Put it into there and the rest of the stuff will go away. Huh. Keeping track of all the stuff that I have. This is why I need some bigger boxes, but I think, in fact, I have... enough nails to make myself two bigger boxes. Might have to do that right now. While I'm doing that though, hunting knife needs 20 forged iron, wood, leather, duct tape. Okay, I have just enough forged iron, wood, leather, duct tape. Is that enough? That is enough. I'll make you in here once again to save my own inventory space while I'm doing other things. There we go. That's crafting away. I will quickly put all you guys back and get... Actually, I need that wood, don't I? Get you... Get you. I don't really know which box I'm going to change over first. I'll just whatever comes to mind. Maybe even the sellables or something. I want to keep my couch. Nah, it'll be fine. It'll be fine. I'll also put them back where they started. That'll be okay. This one is materials like that. And this one over here is food and first aid. There we go. You go food and meds, but sure, whatever. I chose to upgrade those boxes because normally, like, my materials box is pretty stacked full. That's in the wrong box. Go you back out. And my food and first aid because it handles two and often sometimes three different categories of things. That needs to be pretty big as well. This is like my tools and things. You can go into there. Same with you guys. All right, good. Real quick, in fact, now that my hunting knife should be done, I'll grab you out and I'll quickly swap over that brown dye in honor of the poo knife that we found in the toilet way back when. Thank you. You are not worth very much. I might have to scrap you, actually. There we go. 60 iron. It's actually pretty good for me. Right. New knife. In fact, what are you... How much better are you? 8 and 29 compared to 5 and 22. So definitely better. Definitely a good call. Real quick. Machete. I have to find the machete schematic. I can't just unlock it by specking into blades. I also need machete parts. So it's kind of like... With like that top tier stuff, you do need to find the specific schematic for it and find parts for it. So that'll have to happen at some point down the road. Even that though, that tier 4 machete would be like end game kind of tier. That's some really good stuff. I don't have much clay saw, but I'll grab what I do have. Go over to here. If I don't have an anvil somewhere, I do. I was gonna say, I'm pretty sure I found one at some point along the trip. You can go there. Do I have any bellows? No, can I make some bellows? Advanced bellows, not unless I find a schematic for it. It's pretty cheap to make as well. That's okay though. Gone are the days back in the day. We had to make a bellows to make a forge. I don't miss those days. But you can have some fuel like that. And I'll start just melting in some of you guys. If I don't need all my iron in there, actually, it's a little bit daft of me. Let's go probably only, yep, 2 frames worth, a couple of minutes. That should be fine. So it's going to take what? It's 3 seconds per pop and I've got about 60 of them. So that's about 3 minutes worth. So that's about right. That's nice. Good. Okay. So that's all going to melt into there. Then I can start making myself some forged iron. So myself some better tools. So that's fine. But this is the stuff that I've been talking about before where having things running like a forge or chemistry stations or campfires and stuff, anything running increases the heat level of the block that you're in. The higher the heat level gets, the more chance it has of calling in a screamer. When it gets to a certain point, it just calls in a scout, which is a screamer who comes in and starts wrecking your face. So only run these things if you have defenses to defend against that kind of stuff, or just be a bit more judicious about when you do or don't run it. That should be fine, just the one for now. Having like a combination of torches and candles and the forge might cause me an issue, but we'll just have to find out, I suppose. But I'm gonna have to leave this episode here, I think. We're really kicking on. We're really doing some good stuff. So tomorrow, I will go and I will see Trady, get a new job from him. What am I gonna do for a horde base? It's about time now that I start thinking about, like, horde base preparations. Being stealthy doesn't mean shit on a horde. Knives are good. Guns are good. It's never gonna be more of, like, a gun-heavy horde than I suppose, because knives... When zombies are fast and you don't get the benefit of slowing them down with a stab and running away, letting them bleed out, knives are less useful, so it's probably going to be more of a pistol horde night, but we'll see how we go with that. In fact, pistol. I need to make it in the workbench, but I have handgun parts. Maybe I'll start working towards making myself a good quality pistol for down the road. What about like a Magnum? 44 Magnum, need the schematic, or the Dolcher. They both need handgun parts as well. Okay, so definitely handguns. What about like an SMG then? SMG, need the schematic, handgun parts, and some steel. We'll think about it. We'll try. We'll see how far we can get. But yeah, definitely going to be a firearm heavy horde night, which means I could just defend really anywhere. But I'll have to figure all that out in the next episode, because this episode is done. So thank you guys for watching. Most of all, thank you to the patrons on Patreon who made this episode possible. If you haven't liked, make sure you hit the like button down below and subscribe to this channel. Follow me on Twitter. If I talk to you there first, I'll see you in the next episode. Have a good one.